Folks, winter is officially here. 2020 and the holiday season have come and gone, and it is time to think about that early trout season. For a lot of you Midwest folks, a lot of the states have finally began to open up their early trout season. And that's kind of good news and bad news in a way. The good news for us is that there's gonna be a ton, I mean, hundreds of miles worth of amazing trout streams that are now open to us anglers for this early catch and release season. The bad news is that old Jack Frost has kind of, he's gotten comfortable, man. The weather is looking so rough. And yeah, I think we're gonna be gridlocked, stuck in this lovely apartment for the next few weeks, waiting for that warmer weather. Now, just because I can't offer you up any hot wintertime fishing action, I can give away my top three wintertime fishing tips and tricks. Now, a lot of them have to do with being warm and staying warm, and some might seem kind of common sense, but man, I got this one out of left field. It is a game changer and has seriously made the difference on many days out on the cold water. But without any more rambling, let's get into the video. Wait, pause. We gotta do one more thing. All you OG subs watching right now, you freaking know who you are. Thank you so much for sticking around, watching all these videos. Your support seriously means the world to me, and y'all are the freaking best. And you folks on the peripherals, oh, clicking in every now and again, what's Mike up to? Ooh, where's he fishing this time? Ooh, drippy, dimey, blah, blah. I appreciate the view, and thank you so much for just being here and watching the helter-skelter that is fly all season. But now, without any more rambling, let's get into these hot tips and tricks. And for my first one, I gotta go grab some real quick. I'll be right back. Yes, I know what you're thinking. Baby oil. Mike, that's a bit strange, and I completely understand. Also, free, huge shout out to Johnson & Johnson. But for real, folks, when you're trying to fish in these wintertime conditions, everything out there is trying to claw the heat away from you and create this nice, cold, dead corpse to leave in the river. So it is so important to try and stay as warm as you can when you're out fishing. And let's be honest, layers have diminishing returns. You can only put on so many under layers and, you know, pairs of pants and socks and all that crap before your wrists are all cut off from circulation, you can't feel your feet anymore, and you look like the Michelin Man trying to do a roll cast with bricks for hands. I mean, that, it just does not work. And this whole concept of baby oil has kind of an interesting story, so do not click off this video yet. I'm gonna justify my semi-insane reasoning behind lathering my body head to toe before I go out every time in the winter. And to start this story off, I should just say I'm a big podcast and an audiobook guy. I'm always taking in new information as much as I can. And over the last 2 years, I've developed such a kind of tragic but also romantic fascination with a lot of the native tribes here in the United States and other areas of North America. And particularly, you know, the Navajo, the Cheyenne, the Comanches, and also the Northern Sioux. All these Great Plains tribes have such amazing and well-documented, from one perspective, histories in the last, you know, 200 some odd years. And a parallel throughout, when I was reading through the histories, the memoirs, is that a lot of these tribes used rendered down animal fats in these colder months for things like early season, late season raids, river crossings, hunts, essentially anything that required them to be out in the elements, the colder elements I should say, and needing a little bit more insulation. And that's what they would do. They'd take like bear fat or buffalo fat and just head to toe rub themselves down, and it would keep them so freaking warm. And the light bulb just kind of went off. I'm like, why the hell am I not doing that? Being out in the cold and the wet and the nasty, like having that extra layer would be so key. And because bear fat and buffalo fat aren't exactly commercially available, I was like, what's the next best option? And that being a little bit of Johnson & Johnson baby oil, it essentially acts as the same thing. It's that extra layer of oil protecting yourself from all that cold. And I tell you what, folks, I don't know why I'm giving this away, because it is seriously such a freaking hot tip. This has saved my ass so many times. And you end up smelling great. A little bit of eucalyptus, a little bit of coconut oil, smelling nice in the water, catching some fish, staying warm. It is seriously, do not sleep on this tip. It is a big, big W. But That being said, we gotta look at the next tip, and I gotta go grab some more things. I'll be right back. For tip number two, I'm gonna keep this short and I'm gonna keep it simple. Let's talk about pre-rigged leaders. And to do that, I wanna paint just a little bit of a picture. Imagine you're out there, you haven't seen a trout in months, it's been cold, it's been nasty, and the first nice day comes along and the sun's a shining, it's like a nice 30 degrees out, and you're, ooh man, getting that cast back. Oh yeah, I know how to cast. Boom, up into this nice run. You're thinking everything's looking great. Oh man, here we go. Boom, indicator goes down. You set that hook. And as soon as you set that hook, snap, gone. We just lost our entire freaking rig. And next thing you know, sunshine goes away, the sleet comes, the rain, the clouds, whatever it is, the wind picks up, and you're left there with bricks for hands, trying to, you know, make a knot and a good connection, whatever it might be. But seriously, folks, we've all been there, and it is soul crushing to the degree that it makes you just want to go back to the car and freaking go home. But 15 minutes the night before making some pre-rigged leaders could save you 15% or more on your overall sanity as an angler if you just take the time and make some pre-rigged leaders. I do this before every single outing, no joke. Be it dry fly, streamer, even my nymph rigs, I'll have different sections of tippet, different lengths, different weights for all of my rigs, and it saves such a crazy amount of time, man, because when I'm out on the water, I want it to be as efficient as possible, and having those bottlenecks of cold fingers and knots trying to do it all in cold conditions, it's not ideal. In an apartment, a nice warm environment where you can warm up your hands, or you can just, I don't know, do whatever you need to do, it's so much easier to tie strong knots, have great connections, and be able to store them away for whenever you need to use them. So one knot fixes your entire issue of, holy cow, I just broke my entire rig off. It may seem like common sense, folks, but it is seriously still a hot, hot tip. And for my third and final tip, again, I guess I gotta go grab some. I'll be right back. Good golly, Miss Molly. Hot Hands and Johnson & Johnson are getting the freest shout outs today. I tell you, what am I doing? But I know what you're thinking. Mike, wow, cool dude, doing the whole Hot Hands thing. Oh, never heard that one before. I get it, and I understand, but hear me out here. I've gone through my fair share of trial and errors with the Hot Hands. You know, oh, hey, here's a good idea, let's shove them in a glove. Well, you catch a fish, it's wet, the Hot Hands doesn't work anymore. There you go, an hour of warm, now you're cold. Or, oh, I'll shove them down my waders, dude, it'd be perfect. Oh yeah, that seems like great, but then you get to walking, and the next thing you know, your Hot Hands has moved all the way down from your legs, calf, now it's in your feet, and you're stepping on your Hot Hands and it hurts. Now you can't really walk too much anymore, gotta take your waders off, blah, blah. It's a nightmare mess. But what I've gotten to do is I'll take just a little bit of, well, I mean, I use electrical tape, but you can really use any kind of tape. And on my third or fourth layer, just before my outer shell, what I'll do is I'll tape Hot Hands to my forearms and just below my calf. And that tape, it doesn't cut off circulation, but it's just sticky enough to keep those Hot Hands in place all day, feeding a really nice source of heat to your extremities, like your hands and your feet. Because let's be real, folks, when you're out there, you don't want to be miserable. And if you got cold hands and you got cold feet, it can be borderline miserable. So just having that little extra heat feeding all dang day can really make a difference as far as tying knots, making casts, walking, being able to maneuver a little bit more, I guess, nimbly, instead of walking on bricks and trying to tie hand, you know, with your hands being all cold. It's just, it's a mess. But with that being said, that is my third and final wintertime fishing tip. Johnson & Johnson, head to toe. Pre-rig your leaders, folks, 15% or more. And finally, a little bit of Hot Hands taped up. But those are not the end all be all. Those are just mine. And I would love to hear, what do you guys do in the wintertime? Give me your tips and tricks, comment down below, let us all know. I'd love to hear. But folks, for real, thank you so much for sticking around, watching this video. I hope you learned something. I hope you gather something, use it whenever you're going out, because wintertime is a great time to be out on the water. And wherever you find yourself this winter, gosh darn it, keep those feet in the water, those hands nice and warm, and until next time, folks, tight lines.